Today we're talking about badass women in history, specifically Nancy Wake. Born August 30th, 1912, died August 7th, 2011. Nancy Wake and her family moved to Sydney, Australia from their home in New Zealand when she was just 20 months old. She ran away from home when she was 16 and found work as a nurse, but a windfall enabled her to leave Australia for Europe in 1932. Wake settled in Paris working for the Hearst Group of newspapers as a journalist. The rise of German fascism formed the basis of many of her stories. In November of 1939, Nancy married Henry Fioca, a wealthy industrialist. 6 months later, Germany invaded France. Both Nancy Wake and her husband, Henry Fioca, joined the fledgling resistance after France's surrender in 1940. For 2 years, they worked as couriers for the resistance, and later participated in an escape network to get downed Allied soldiers back to safety. Nancy became a saboteur, organizer, and resistance fighter who led an army of 7,000 Marquis troops in guerrilla warfare to sabotage the Nazis. She became one of the most fearsome French resistance fighters during World War II. By 1942, the Gestapo, which is the Nazi police force, had put her at the top of their most wanted list, offering a 5 million franc prize, which equals about 5,081,740 US dollars today, for her capture, dead or alive. They referred to her as the White Mouse, as she had managed to evade capture throughout her involvement in the war. Eventually, it became too dangerous for her to continue her work in France's borders. The Nazis were basically stalking her, tapping her phones and stuff like that. So she left her husband behind to continue their work in Paris while she traveled to Britain. Soon after her departure, her husband was captured and tortured for information on her whereabouts, which he did not divulge, which unfortunately cost him his life. Nancy did not learn of his death until after the war. Once in Britain, Wake joined the Special Operatives Executives, also known as the SOE, and was trained in several combat and intelligence programs. Her training officers noted that she was a quick learner, a fast shot, and could put the men to shame. Before long, she was a high-ranking officer in the SOE and in charge of organizing and allocating arms to 7,500 men. She also led several attacks on the Gestapo, and at one point offered to personally execute a German spy that her men were too afraid to kill themselves. Her most notable achievement, though, was when the SOE were raiding a German gun factory. As an investigating SS sentry was about to raise the alarm and give her and her crew away, Wake killed the guard with her bare hands. Wake further proved her devotion to the resistance when she rode 380 miles round trip on a bicycle through German checkpoints to transfer a message from her resistance group to another, all within a 72-hour period. Throughout the war, Nancy Wake saved thousands of lives. She was awarded the Medal of Freedom by the U.S., the Medaille de la Résistance, and the Croix de Guerre from France, and countless other honors from European nations. Her fellow resistance officer said this about her: "She's the most feminine woman I know until the fighting starts. Then she's like five men." Nancy Wake is truly a badass woman in history.